Hello and welcome to Our Savior's Lutheran Church here in Stillwater, Minnesota. We are so glad that you are joining us today and we invite you to come again. Our worship times are 8 o'clock traditional here in the sanctuary, online pre-recorded as you've discovered, and 10:30 contemporary in our larger space, the CLC. We also have a Wednesday night worship, 5 o'clock meal, 5:30 worship with programs for all ages to follow. We can't wait to see you in person, and we also are so excited for those of you worshiping online as well. Know that you are always welcome here. We are so glad you're with us, and we invite you to come again.
Well, friends, as we make confession of our sin together, we begin in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of your Holy Spirit that we may confess our sin, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Now let us confess our sin in the presence of God and one another. Join me, please. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. And together we say, Amen. Well, friends, in the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us of all of our sins. And so today, as a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ, and by Christ's authority alone, I therefore declare to us the entire forgiveness of all our sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Open the eyes and find the heart. I want to see.
grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and also with you. Let us pray together. Holy and righteous God, you are the author of life, and you adopt us to be your children. Fill us with your words of life, that we may live as witnesses to the resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Gospel according to St. Luke, the 24th chapter. While they were talking about this, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you frightened, and why do doubts arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet and see that it is I myself. Touch me and see, for a ghost does not have flesh and bone as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy they were disbelieving and still wondering, he said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of broiled fish. He took it and ate it in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I am still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. And he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things, and see, I am sending upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." The Gospel of the Lord. Well, friends, let's begin this time together in a prayer. Wonderful Lord, we thank you for this powerful story of your resurrection appearance. May we also recognize your presence in our daily lives, that you always bring hope and new life. And especially in this season of spring, may we recognize new life everywhere we go. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. They were so terrified when Jesus was suddenly showed up in that room, they thought he was a ghost. Now, when I heard that, the ghost part of it reminded me that a week ago when I was on vacation, Brian and I went to the latest Ghostbusters movie. Yes, this wonderful film that came out in the 80s. There's a new version now and takes place with the grandkids of the original Ghostbusters and how they are trying to figure out how to keep the city safe. Well, I won't give any spoiler alerts, but in this movie Ghostbusters, there's a teenage girl who is in living. She's in the flesh. She's the grandchild of the Harold Ramis character that had previously died, right? And there's a ghost about the same age as her, maybe a year older. And the two become friends and want so much to be able to connect, but they live in different dimensions. One is a ghost, and you can kind of poke and see through, and you can't really have that type of connection that you would want, right? It's a movie. But here, there was definitely dimensions that separated them. Now, I bring this up because Jesus, here he had risen from the grave. He had appeared to the disciples here for the first time in Luke, for the 12, which was actually now the 11. And they wonder if he's a ghost or a phantom. Certainly not a figment of their imagination, because group hallucination wouldn't probably be that common or that possible. But what kind of resurrected body is this Jesus? What dimensional plane is he on? Because he seems to appear in rooms. He shows up unexpectedly. He would later ascend to the heavens. And as 1 Corinthians 15 would go on to explain about how this perishable body must put on imperishability, and that in the twinkling of an eye, when the trumpet sounds and the dead will be raised imperishable, it talks about how the resurrected body would not be a body that would decay and decompose. It would be different than the raising of Lazarus that happened in John the 11th chapter, because this Lazarus who was raised from the dead by Jesus would die again, right? But with Jesus, the resurrection, this resurrected body is a whole new embodied form. And what dimensional plane would be Jesus be on? And there is profound mystery in that. I was looking up the different dimensions. One dimensional is kind of an impossibility, just kind of a dot. Two dimensional would be point A to point B, like a line. But three dimensional is height and width and breadth, sense of substance to it. And yet, the fourth and fifth dimension having to do with time and space, this awe and this mystery, we're not really fully sure what this embodied resurrection is. But there's something to that thought of the disciples needing to have a three-dimensional Jesus, a Jesus that they could touch and see the wounds in his hands and his feet. A Jesus that would show up in the room when they were in great despair, giving them incredible hope and promise. A Jesus that could actually digest fish and share a meal with them. It's interesting, too, that I think if I were to rise from the dead, I don't know if my first meal that I would want would necessarily be fish, unless it were salmon, of course. But there was something to that Jesus showing up in the flesh, in a resurrected body, that they needed tangible evidence of the risen Christ. And I think about too how in that incarnational ministry, in the flesh, Jesus showing up, giving peace, that three-dimensional body of height, width, and depth. There's a wonderful Bible verse from Ephesians 3, 17 to 19. It says this: "So that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, and I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have the power, together with all of the Lord's holy people, to grasp how wide and how long and how high and how deep is the love of Christ, and to know that this love surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all fullness of God." Isn't that a beautiful image to think? Really three-dimensional here, how wide and long and high and deep. Have you thought about that before? That description that St. Paul gives, how wide and long and high and deep, looks like the form of a cross, of this God that will never leave us or forsake us, that tangible evidence of God with us even to the end of the age. That, my friends, is faith with substance. Faith that you can see and touch and experience. Faith in which Jesus would eat fish to show his resurrection and reassurance to the disciples. And how can we have that faith with substance? That three-dimensional, I can see it, I can grasp it, I can touch it today. Our elementary kids here at Our Saviors will be having their first communion this Sunday. And this past week, we had a wonderful time right here in the sanctuary as I gave them instruction. And they were able to taste a little bit and be able to experience knowledge and understanding of who Jesus is in greater depths through his love for us in communion. And I shared with them this story that is a powerful story about a woman named Sarah Miles that these children, they're getting First Communion in elementary school. Sarah Miles wrote a book, a memoir called Take This Bread, and her First Communion she didn't have until she was in her 40s. And when she did, it absolutely changed her life. She was not raised in the church. Her grandparents were Christians, but her parents were not. And she didn't really know much about Christianity or that faith at all. She had done some humanitarian work in South America, and whenever she did, she noticed that there would be Christians there that would also be working alongside her, doing some great work of justice, and it really intrigued her. And when she moved back to California to settle and to become a chef, she noticed that every time she would go to work to and from, she would walk past a beautiful church that had incredibly gorgeous stained glass. She loved the architecture and thought, one of these days I'm going to have to go and walk inside. And so she did. And they happened to be in the middle of worship. And the invitation was open to come to the Lord's table and experience for themselves, to taste and see that the Lord is good, to have physical, tangible evidence of a loving God. She stepped forward, and it was an Episcopal church. And when the words were spoken, this is the body of Christ, the bread from heaven. This is the blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. She tasted that bread, she drank that wine, and she experienced a profound sense of the love and presence and spirit of Jesus. One of her quotes in her book, Take This Bread, she writes, "Communion. I chewed and swallowed it. It was at the absolute center of my faith. Wheat and water and yeast and heat, grape and sun and thyme, bread and wine transformed into my life. I ate it up and kept coming back for more. And yet, even though the church was where I found communion, church couldn't finally contain it." Sarah was inspired, tasted and saw a three-dimensional God, one where physical evidence from the bread and the wine, that we have a God that knows us, loves us, went to the cross on our behalf to die and rise again to give us new and abundant life. May we trust each and every day and be on the lookout for this resurrected Jesus, for God shows up in unexpected places and through unexpected people in wondrous ways, revealing to us his deep love, his promise, and his provision. God is with you always, a God that is close and dear, and one that we can truly taste and see the goodness of God. God bless. Amen.
We appreciate your offerings in support of our continuing ministry at Our Savior's Lutheran Church, a caring community called by Christ to serve and live in faith. Contributions can be made by check, text, online, or mobile app. For details, please see Donate on our website at oslcstillwater.org. Thank you for sharing from the abundance with which God has blessed you.
Let us confess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
With the whole people of God in Christ Jesus, let us pray for the church, those in need, and all of God's creation. Precious Lord Jesus, we thank you for our victory over the grave. May this message of hope and new life resonate in our souls and fill us with joy. May we also notice your presence everywhere we go. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. The earth is yours, Lord, and everything in it. You watch over the cattle on 1,000 hills. You created all things and gave us new life. May we be good stewards of the earth you have created. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Precious Jesus, we thank you that you have given us the gifts of baptism and Holy Communion. The water, bread, and wine reminds us of your presence and your spirit here among us. Bless the children of our Savior's Lutheran that are receiving their first communion today. May they taste and see that you are good. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, your first words to your disciples after the resurrection was, "Peace be with you." May our whole world experience your peace and wars. Bring resolution and your love throughout the planet. We especially pray for peace in the Holy Land, in Ukraine, Sudan, Ethiopia, and Haiti. Send your extra measure of blessing to our Anuak friends, as there has been severe violence in Sudan and Ethiopia. Protect the children and send your comforting spirit of peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for our mission partners throughout the globe, locally, regionally, and internationally. Bless our Anuak friends, Habitat for Humanity, Open Hands Midway, Mission Jamaica, Tanzania, and Guatemala. Strengthen our partnerships with all our friends throughout the planet. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, you are the great physician. Send your healing to all that need your loving presence and assurance. We especially pray for those within our community, family and friends, including Linda Moskalik, Georgia Herberg, Doris Walima, Carla Tietzel, Steve Clary, Tara Lestock, Jean Johnson, Jerry Griffith, Nancy Sodi, Nancy Whalen, Andy Nelson, Steve Glazer, Meredith Kasky, Kim Robel, Barry Klepper, Kathy Kramer, Nate Trepanier, Chris Leminski, Perry Price, Lee Johnson, Pastor Maury Hagen, Carol and Larry Tossett. And for Helen Olson, as she's nearing the end of her life, Lord, we just lift her up to you. Grieving the family and friends of Mike Reynolds, Lord, as they grieve his death, we just pray and lift them up as well. And all of these prayers we lift up to you, O Lord, knowing that you hear us and that you love us. In Jesus' name, amen.
And now as we enter into the service of Holy Communion, it was in the night in which he was betrayed that our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. He gave thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples to eat. He said, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you." He said, "Do this in remembrance of me." Well, then again, after supper, he took the cup. And after giving thanks, he gave it for all to drink. He said, "This cup is the new covenant of my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins." And once again, he said, "Do this in remembrance of me." And on this day, let's join together in the prayer Jesus taught us to pray. Join me, please. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. As we join together today, I would invite you to take your wafer or cracker or cookie, whatever you have, and we hold this up, and together as the family of faith, let us say these words. This is the body of Christ broken for me, and let's receive this together. And now we take that cup of wine or grape juice, whatever it may be. Again, let's hold this up as the family of faith and say these words together. This is the blood of Christ shed for me. And we share this together. And receive the communion blessing. May the body and blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, strengthen us all and keep us in his grace now and forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We have several birthdays and anniversaries in our congregation in the coming week. Birthdays include Stephanie Perkins, Sam McCoy, Seth Olson, Mason Carbon, Xander Carbon, Tracy Glazer, Margaret Reed, Dave Shaw, Karen McLaren, Patty McCluskey, Tanner Call, Cameron Ligdy, Najee Sutherland, Stephen Russell, Nathan Mazanik, Sylvia King, Maria Redmond, Carter Gustafson, Jan Lepla, Lara Atsuka, Dan Colburn, and Adam Shore. And anniversaries include Paul and Elaine Hegernis, and Dick and Georgia Herberg. So let's offer prayers for those celebrating life milestones. O God, our times are in your hand. Look with favor, we pray, in your servants as they begin another year. Grant that they may grow in wisdom and grace, and strengthen their trust in your goodness all the days of their lives, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's join together in singing. Alleluia! Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia! The God of resurrection power, the Christ of unending joy, and the Spirit of Easter, hope bless you now and always. Amen. Go in peace. Serve the risen one. Thanks be to God.